Have you ever noticed when you look at your photos, there's an area that always seems to be a little bit too dark? It's not quite in the blacks, but just there in the mid-tone shadows. You almost always need to open that up. Let me show you how to do it right now in Photoshop. Let's just open this photo in Camera Raw. We're going to choose Filter, Camera Raw, Filter. Now, the particular tool we're going to use here is only found in Camera Raw and in Lightroom. But first of all, let's just do a quick exposure adjustment just to kind of brighten it up a little bit. Notice as we do this, the background becomes too bright, so we're going to take the highlight and we're going to pull that back. Now, as you can see, there's that area that just always seems plugged up. There's a lot of black and darks in this photo, and it really shows it well. You know, we want to see a little detail in these areas, but we don't want to lose the blacks. Now, one of the areas that we can go is we can open up the shadows, and this is usually where people go, and this works well. Look at this. It brings out a lot of the detail, but it can make things look shiny and a little artificial. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you another tool that we can use, and that's curves. Curves have the ability to target a specific tone inside an image in a way that you can't with any other tool. Show you a special type of curve, and that's a parametric curve. If we click on the first adjustment, you'll notice that it comes with these little sliders. It's almost like curves on trainer wheels, but it has some hidden power. In fact, I'm just going to show you the trick right now, and then I'll explain what I did. Let's take these points all the way to the left. And now we can take the darks, and as we open up the darks, notice it's lifting that tonal region that we want to get where a lot of those issues happen. Notice as we're moving this, it's only hitting that region and not too much of the rest of the image. All right, let me explain what happened and the best way to use this. So the parametric curves are different than other curves in that I make the adjustment within these four regions. And if you look in between these dots, there's shadows, darks, lights, highlights. Shadows, darks, lights, highlights. So these will move the region, lightening or darkening those specific regions. Now, these sliders determine where that region is. If I move this, see how that region now becomes larger and now it starts to encompass the midtones all the way up to the highlights. So I can choose where I want to hit these. It's almost like luminosity masking. So we're not affecting the blacks, just the midtone shadows, but notice as I move this slider, notice, look at these regions between our subject here. See how they get protected or they get included. So this enables you to get down to a very, very specifically tight area. Now, what can work really well is if we take these darks and we open them up, notice now we have a very realistic adjustment. Now, we can use this in combination with the shadows. If I give this a little bit of shadow, notice it gives it some pop, but it still looks natural. It doesn't look artificial whether we open the shadows too much. So I find using this in a combination with the curves can give you a very specific adjustment inside of your photos to hit that area that always seems a little bit too dark and just lift it and open it up. And here's our before and after. And by the way, if you haven't been using curves, they are the most powerful tool inside of Photoshop. It's the only tool that enables you to specifically pinpoint a tone or a color and make very specific adjustments on it. Now, these can seem daunting at first, so I've created a course. It's actually a 2-hour course on mastering curves where we're going to start from the very beginning. I explain to you how curves work, and then I show you how to use these to take control over the colors and tones in your images. So check out my brand new course, which is officially launching today. There's a code in the link that'll give you 20% off. So let me know in the comments, are you guys using curves and were you aware of the parametric curve and how powerful it really is? If you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. Don't forget, hit that like button, it helps with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.